Couples who are trying to conceive often find that the male partner has an abnormal semen analysis. What options are available to improve your ability to become pregnant? Today on Infertility TV, I will discuss three options that you should consider. A semen analysis is one of the male fertility tests, and it is pretty simple. A man ejaculates into a cup, the fluid is then examined under a microscope. We first see if there are any sperm. Some men have none. If there are sperm, then we can see how many sperm there are, how many are moving, and how many have a normal size and shape. Watch this video to learn how to read and understand a semen analysis. What should you do if you or your partner has an abnormal semen analysis? I will discuss three different options, but the first thing to do is to repeat the analysis. Why? Well, it turns out that there is a lot of variation in sperm numbers. Men with perfectly normal fertility will sometimes have an abnormal semen analysis. It is the couples who have a persistently abnormal semen analysis that are likely to have problems becoming pregnant. Let me show you what I mean. In one study, scientists recruited 5 men to collect 15 to 20 semen specimens over about a year and a half. They measured how many sperm there were, which is called sperm concentration. When they analyzed the concentration over time, they saw something pretty amazing. There was a huge amount of fluctuation. The first man collected 16 semen specimens. Most of them were in the 40 to 100 million range, which is normal. However, on his third specimen, the concentration jumped to 250 million. On the 13th specimen, it was close to zero. If this man had done only one semen analysis, and it happened to be on this day, we would have mistakenly concluded that this man had a severe fertility problem, when in reality, he was likely fertile the majority of the time. In subject number 3, we saw several times when sperm numbers were normal, alternating with times when they were low. Subject number 5 had persistently low sperm concentration over the entire course of the study. This is the guy most likely to have fertility issues. How many semen analyses should a man have? There is no perfect answer to that question. In general, the more analyses you do, the better your chances are for accurately diagnosing whether a man has a fertility problem or not. Most fertility experts would recommend doing 2 or 3. The first option for improving the odds for pregnancy in couples with an abnormal semen analysis are male testing and treatment. Some men will have an identifiable cause for their poor sperm quality. Appropriate treatment in some of those men can improve sperm quality enough to increase the chance for pregnancy. Some of the correctable problems that we can test for are hormone problems, such as low testosterone levels, thyroid problems, elevated prolactin levels, or inadequate stimulation of the testicles from the pituitary gland. It is important to understand that you may not find a correctable cause in many men. Treatment of these problems does not always result in improvement or enough improvement to make a difference in your chances for pregnancy. Another option for improving fertility is called intrauterine insemination, or IUI. This is when sperm are injected directly into the uterus at the time of ovulation. This can increase the number of sperm that reach the fallopian tubes where fertilization occurs, and therefore improve the odds for pregnancy. If a semen analysis is mildly abnormal, IUI can be an effective option, which is easy to do and relatively inexpensive. Watch this video for my ultimate guide to getting pregnant with IUI. The third option for improving fertility is called in vitro fertilization, or IVF. IVF is a very powerful method to bypass an abnormal semen analysis. Instead of putting sperm into a woman's body to fertilize the eggs are removed and fertilized in the laboratory. The technique we use to fertilize the eggs is called ICSI. With this technique, we inject a single sperm into a single egg. This dramatically lowers the number of sperm that we need to get fertilization. So IVF is an excellent technique for couples that have even a very severely abnormal semen analysis. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. Make sure that a sperm problem is real by repeating the semen analysis. If it is real, there are three methods you can use to improve your odds for pregnancy. In addition to hosting Infertility TV every week, I am a practicing physician. If you would like to have a consultation with me by video, check out my website at IVF1.com. But before you go, make sure you subscribe to Infertility TV now. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.